Okay, so you've done your consultation, you've done your exams, you did your 2-week diet, all the way up to the surgery table, and then they open you up to find out you cannot do the surgery because you failed the pre-op diet. Why would you do that to yourself?
Ain't nothing wrong with that. So tell me that, tell me that. Tell me on the best diet. I'll be feeling like your son.
Hello guys, welcome to my channel, Reinventing Trina. Yes, we are talking about the pre-op diet. Whew. Is it hard? Is it easy? What is the diet plan? What is the meal plan? Stick around. I'm about to tell you about it. Please like and subscribe to get more videos like these. Let's get to it. So you're on your weight loss journey and you have decided that you are going to have the VSG surgery. And so what is the pre-op diet? The pre-op diet is a liver reduce kit that's given to you from your doctor that is gonna be 2 weeks or 14 days that you're gonna have to follow. It is very strict. My doctor is very, very strict. It is an all liquid diet, and that is to help reduce your liver so they can perform the surgery. You do not want to get to your surgery and they open you up to find out that you did not follow the diet properly. That's a whole nother video, but yes, that can happen. You run the risk of not having surgery by not doing your pre-op diet. So Trina, what is the pre-op diet? The pre-op diet is straight liquids. It's 14 days of protein drinks and protein bars. It is a high protein, low carb, low calorie diet or meal plan. I like to say meal plan, but it says pre-op diet all through the package, so whichever. I followed my doctor's recommendations and I went what was in his office. He has this bariatric fusion liver kit, shrink your liver kit in the office, and I went with his. Now, sidebar, people that know me, and if you don't know me, I do not like protein drinks. But guess what? Trina drank the protein drinks because I had the surgery. However, if you have food sensitivities or allergies, or you have a preference of your own shake, that's completely fine. You just want to make sure that your label, it reads that it's less than 10 grams of carbs and 20 to 13 grams of protein when it's fully made. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the meal plan and explain what your day-to-day is like for 14 days. And this is exactly 2 weeks prior. So exactly 14 days before surgery. So to be exact, my protein intake, my pre-op diet actually began July the 10th because my surgery was on the 24th of July. So everything began July 10th. So your meal plan consists of, for breakfast, you're going to have a bariatric fusion protein shake. And once again, that's in my doctor's. You can order it online. I will put the description down below. And you guys, I don't like protein shakes, but I actually liked them. I had three options to choose from. I had a coffee, which I love coffee. I had a chocolate flavor, and then I had an all berry flavor. Interesting. My favorite was coffee, of course, because I love coffee, all things coffee. But this is what you're back to it. Sorry, let me get back on the meal plan. So your breakfast is going to be a protein drink. Your AM snack is going to be a protein bar. Then for lunch, another great, nice protein shake. Then your PM is going to be a protein bar. And then for dinner, you're going to have a protein shake. Yes. Liquids on top of liquids on top of liquids on top of liquids. Oh, did I say on top of liquids? Yeah. Yes, liquids. I have liquid here. No, it's not wine, it's water. I gotta say, dehydrated at all times. I just wanna let you know that you don't have to use water. You can use 6 to 8 ounces of fat-free milk, unsweetened almond milk, and water. Those are your three options. During this 2 weeks, you're not having any caffeinated beverages, no caffeine or Cokes or coffee. You got to put that to the side for 2 weeks. You will make it through. I thought I wasn't, but I did. I do want to let you guys know that your intake on hydrating liquids is very crucial, because for 2 weeks, you're only drinking liquids all day. So you have to continue with your life with this crucial. It is very, 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 very crucial. This kicks off your journey to your new you. You know, I said, if I cannot absolutely not follow this pre-op diet, what do I expect after the surgery? Or will I even have the surgery, because I decided not to listen? But like I said, that's another video. I did have the surgery, so apparently I did listen. You need at least 64 ounces of hydrating fluids that need to be sugar-free, decaffeinated, non-carbonated, and less than 50 calories per 8 ounces. Examples are Crystal Light, Powerade Zero, Propel Zero, etc. I know you guys pretty much know how to read labels. If not, let me know. Put the comments down below if you would like an actual labels video. I wouldn't mind going for it. I wouldn't mind. But you can have unlimited sugar-free popsicles. That was exciting. I got popsicles. Went back to childhood, like a lot of popsicles, because I got tired of drinking, literally. Sugar-free gelatin. I don't like gelatin. My mind just went blank. Oh my gosh. I don't like Jell-O. So I didn't even touch Jell-O. That didn't even apply to me, because the girl doesn't like Jell-O. But you can have low sodium broth. So, hey, what was mine during, what got me through was my protein shake in the morning. I got it over with, you guys. Woke up, had my protein shake. I rock and rolled it. Then had my AM snack protein bar. Once again, the bars were in the kit that my doctor gave me. He had a full kit. It's very nice. I'll put the kit down below. And then for lunch, I just had a broth, a whole lot of broths. And I'm going to have some videos on what type of broths I got. There's so many out there. But yeah. And then I had the protein bar, and I had the protein at night. And then if it's an absolute must, like you just like, oh my gosh, I need something to eat, My doctor, he allowed me to have 3 ounces of white fish, but it's only once a day, not lunch and dinner. So, or you can have a boil, not or, you can have, well, yes, it's an or, but I paired two. So some days I had one of the three, but there was a day that I had one boiled egg and one white egg. I mean, white flaky fish. And I will definitely go over the flaky fish with you guys. It could be a halibut, cod. Those are the top two. Real great. Tilapia, great. But it's down below the bottom like catfish. So you want to keep it up on the healthy side. Yeah, your girl can cook. You'll find out more about that. But yeah, you want to stick with your white flaky fish that is very healthy, which would be halibut, cod. There's more out there. But if you want to do tilapia, that's fine. That's fine. I'm just, you know, I get a little bit extra. I do read labels. So that's just me. But back to your absolutely must, if you absolutely need to eat something. 3 ounces of white flaky fish, 1 hard-boiled egg, or plain Greek yogurt. I didn't touch the plain Greek yogurt because I don't like it alone. I like it mixed in other things. So I pretty much will venture out towards that probably around post-op. Phase 2, tune in because I will make a video on the post-op diet. And those are your options. So I do want to give you guys a disclaimer. I am not a doctor and I do not recommend following this diet to lose weight outside of VSG because this 2-week process shrinks your liver. So please seek your doctors for everything. I'm just giving you the process because we are talking about VSG and I am speaking to those that who are considering, who are in the process, who need help, they need a push, they need a restart, they've already had it and they've hit the stall. We'll hit all of that. This is literally in the VSG process. I do not recommend that you do this and you're not considering surgery because it can be very dangerous because you don't know what your body can and cannot do. So y'all heard me on the fad diets. I just went over that. Don't do this to get a quick, easy 10-pound drop. You know I did drop 10 pounds. But anyways, it was for surgery, people. Surgery. Anyways, I don't want to hold you guys up any longer. I want to thank y'all for tuning in, reinventing Trina, myself, VSG style. And I'm here to give you help, to promote self-care and be content with who you are in the process and to love yourself. Please like and subscribe. I will be dropping more videos like these. Thank you.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. So tell me that, tell me that. Tell me I'm the best I am. I'll be feeling like yes I am.